We have two product lines, our helium and our natural gas. In our helium, we expect, you know, helium sales to commence within the Pecos Slope field. That's definitely a certainty. So that's going to be fun because, again, when you look at kind of our peer groups within that helium market, they're just true exploration plays. How we differentiate, we have what they call proved reserves. So when you look at, you know, the trading companies out there, whether we're on the TSX, the AIM, any other sort of, you know, we're the only one on Nasdaq or NYSE with proved helium other than Exxon.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. Joining me now is Will Gray. He is the CEO of New Era Helium. And Will, it's good to see you. How are you?
Hey, I'm doing well. Yourself?
I'm doing very well. Thanks very much. Good to have you along. Excited to learn a bit more about the company. Tell me about New Era Helium.
Yeah, great. Yeah, would love to. Thank you very much. So obviously, we went public in early December, and New Era Helium was able to ring the bell on January 2nd. So we got to open up the 2025 trading session on Nasdaq. So very exciting. But essentially, New Era Helium was formed to essentially, we produce helium to consolidate and aggregate one of the most fragmented markets you've ever seen on upstream helium, as well as actually take our natural gas and use it for net zero power to assist in AI data centers.
Helium, a lot of people are used to it in certain ways, but helium is super important in short supply. So maybe explain to everyone a bit about why helium is so important.
Yeah, exactly. Because everyone automatically assumes, hey, it's balloons, right? Which they're not wrong. They're not incorrect. But essentially, you know, when you look at the overall market, 10 balloons only make up roughly just under 10% of the global volume. So what's interesting is, you know, when we first got into helium years ago, really understanding the end use applications. And prior to, you know, it was MRIs. That was your number one end use application. You can't run an MRI without helium because of the cooling of the super magnets. But what has really been of interest of late is how the advancement of semiconductors, more specifically AI data chips, you cannot have that without helium. So semiconductors have actually overtaken MRIs as the number one end use application. And of course, this scarce commodity is greatly in need. It's a critical element listed, you know, both in the EU and the US. But of course, you know, you start looking at healthcare, life science, obviously aerospace. And of course, you know, part of the energy transition is utilization within of nuclear reactors.
I noticed that when I was researching the company, you had just sort of finalized a joint venture to develop a net zero data center in Texas. Tell me about sort of this move into this for the company and what this all means.
Right. And that's a great question because we've had a lot of inquiries into, well, are you a helium company or are you an AI company or kind of what's going on here? And those are very valid questions. So one thing to note is, you know, for the audience and for investors, you know, one quick fact, 95% of the world's helium is associated with natural gas. So you can say, listen, nat gas is a byproduct of the helium, but at the end of the day, we're still dealing with two products, helium and natural gas. And what we're tasked to do is how do we get the highest price for our natural gas? Do we simply sell it in the pipeline as a molecule, or do we take it and utilize it for power generation and sell it as electricity? So essentially, it makes a lot more sense. The delta is that significant where if you convert the molecule, the nat gas to electricity, it does wonders for your for the profitability of that product line. And so with that being said, we were looking at, you know, do you look at how do we partner on data centers, really specifically, you know, net zero power? And what that means is taking just, you know, nat gas, which has been around forever in regards to power generation, capturing the CO2 from that facility and essentially utilizing that for what they call carbon capture utilization storage. So, you know, zero carbon footprint, you know, in connection with hyperscalers. I think that's kind of the recipe of what people are looking for.
And it gives you also some certainty as well around costs because there's fixed natural gas prices and things like that. So it gives you some certainty for quite a few years.
Absolutely. I think that's one thing that's why we went down this path was obviously, you know, we have long-term offtake agreements for our helium, you know, that are 10 years. And that's one thing, again, I think why we did what we did, because everyone naturally assumes, hey, when you look at CNBC or whatever, you look at the NYMEX price for natural gas, well, that's what people receive. That's not accurate. So essentially, natural gas was actually negative in the Permian Basin because of takeaway capacity. So when you cannot move your natural gas or you get paid nothing for it, you know, you're forced to be creative. And this creativity has really kind of led to the power generation. And I think the Permian Basin is going to be awash in natural gas for decades to come. And the takeaway capacity is not there. So what do we do with it? And to create, you know, net zero power is the obvious choice.
Well, let's talk about 2025. What should people be expecting from the company this year?
Two things. So obviously we have two product lines, our helium and our natural gas. In our helium, we expect, you know, helium sales to commence within the Pecos Slope field. That's definitely a certainty. So that's going to be fun because, again, when you look at kind of our peer groups within that helium market, they're just true exploration plays. How we differentiate, we have what they call proved reserves. So when you look at, you know, the trading companies out there, whether we're on the TSX, the AIM, any other sort of, you know, we're the only one on Nasdaq or NYSE with proved helium other than Exxon. Obviously, we're not Exxon, but of course, we spent a long time working with the SEC to better educate them on how do we appropriately book the helium on our as reserves, because it's not a hydrocarbon. And so it's an inert gas. So that was really fun to kind of really go through that process, understand that. And then our second product line expectations on our natural gas is to really, you know, I think it's multiple stages within that, looking at the data center specifically. So it's called Texas Critical Data Centers, LLC. And obviously, you know, the location of the siting, air permitting, things of that nature. So really kind of moving that 250 net zero power project along to where it's up and going in 2026.
Well, it's going to be pretty exciting for sure. Lots of work ahead. And Will, thanks so much for sharing all of that with us. And we'll keep an eye on your story for sure. Thank you.
All right. Well, thank you very much for having us on and look forward to joining next time.
All right. Sounds good. Look forward to it. Will Gray, the CEO of New Era Helium.